Charlottesville. And some people might ask, what's a public artist? Well, a public artist is somebody who just needs to get ready. To get ready to just show their art wherever, because we need to make a living, but also people need to see it. So you have to put it out in the general public. And so one of my concerns is, would this possibly be a nice lighting area? So I basically put my paintings just anywhere, but sometimes I really like the fact that there's not too much sun on them. And so now, hello?
Hey, Robin, this is Conrad Hunter. I'm the president of Charles Wireless, and I know that you're outside my store. Oh, yes,
I am. Well, is it okay if I come in and maybe do your portrait?
Well, you know, let's go on in. We'd love to come in and see our new store. It'd be fantastic.
Oh, this is so awesome. I'll be right in. I have to get my vest on so I can hold my supplies in it, and also bring in all my colors, because we know you never know what you're going to get. Sometimes you have a lot of colors, sometimes you have a little colors, you don't know what you're going to get. So kind of bring in whatever you can. And this is my paper, my easel. And my table. I wouldn't need my umbrella now because I'm going to be inside. Okay, and then I have to put my paintings away. Because I'm not going to show them right now. My paintings basically have sort of a size thing. Usually I'm a little more careful, but since I'm very local, I don't worry too much about scratching. But see how an artist really has to plan. And it's very difficult. Whatever you do, you know, you have to be very careful not to hurt your paintings. So you have to consider how they're going to move. It's better to wrap them. But since I'm just putting them away for now, I'm not going to wrap them. And I usually wrap them with old sheets, like layers of old sheets. It's our recycling. And I try to make sure when I put the paintings in, they don't scratch. Okay, so let's go in.
Saw you was at the pavilion.
Yes, when you did the honorary donation for the free clinic.
That's right. That's right.
And so maybe if you stand right over here,
okay.
All right. I'll be able to set up my little table over here just right.
Yeah, a lot of stuff.
Yeah, when I'm out in the public as a public artist, I basically have to be ready, and so everything is pretty portable. I go on the farmers markets, raise money for different alliances and this and that.
That's fantastic.
And so Charlottesville has a farmers market, Scottsville has a farmers market, and there's probably like three more in Charlottesville during the week. Penn Park and Mead Park and Forest Lakes.
Okay, nice.
And these are all initiatives to have local people who farm, you know, be able to sell their fresh produce, which gives you more vitamins.
Right, right, that's fantastic.
As long as it doesn't sit around, you know. So, and what I have to do is I have to set up my easel.
Anything I need to help?
No, sir, you're just fine. So, now that we are in this situation, I guess this is your store over here.
This is my store, one of our newer stores, so we're real excited about it.
And hopefully, in this store, you have a lot of local people.
I hope so. That's one of our keynote strategies, is to be the local wireless provider and support local community initiatives and local farmers and produce and anything local. We want to be the dominant player.
So how did this happen? You've been in this business for like 100 years.
Well, not quite 100, maybe in dog years, but no, I've been in telecom since I graduated from college back in 1979. So, and lived all over the country. This is my second stint in Virginia. I lived in Richmond about 10 years ago.
Oh.
And since then, I've been in Tennessee and Illinois, and now I'm back to Virginia again.
Okay. And so, I mean, you are the vice president?
I'm the president and executive vice president of Telus Wireless.
So, and then what is it exactly that your company does for us, the customers?
Well, you know, what we do for our customers is, number one, give you peace of mind, give you security, give you the ability to stay in touch with your family and friends. I think we also give you a great community partner that likes to give back, as evidenced from our donations at the free clinic and lots of other local initiatives we do, United Way. We're real big into that. We have an Intelus Foundation that makes a lot of donations to local service and charitable organizations. And but the biggest thing is just a great customer value for wireless and allowing you to have great service and hopefully a great experience when you walk into any of our stores. This is one of our newest stores. We're really proud of it. And it's designed to make you as a customer feel very, very important and not just a number.
And it's nice in here.
This is nice.
And it's air conditioned. So I'm very happy to have met you.
Same here.
And as we said, you know, the idea was that I raise awareness through my TV show for the free clinic.
That's fantastic.
And the reason why I do that is because I actually was a volunteer. And I was drawing on film. And I learned, and I went through a certificate program, and I did this.
That's awesome.
And then they certified me to be able to do this.
That's great.
So I'm certified.
That's great.
And, you know, be able to raise money is just awesome.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
For you to be so generous to the free clinic. And now, how did you discover the free clinic?
Well, we were working with the Pavilion organization, and just through different contacts and through our CEO and other contacts, we knew the free clinic did so many great things for the local community and just people here that have medical needs that couldn't afford it. And we thought, you know, with our association with the Kidney Foundation and what the free clinic does, we just saw it was a natural fit here in Charlottesville. So that's the reason, that's how we heard about it, and we just think, you know, number one, we want to make sure we're giving back to things that are really important to the community, and this seems to be something that's, it's, you know, there's a lot of leaders throughout the community here that really, really support the free clinic, and we thought, well, what a great idea for Telus Wireless to be part of that, and that's how we got in part with the Pavilion and everything else. It's just a great opportunity.
So, what's
it's very local, and that's just our strategy as well.
So, what's your affiliation, if you don't mind me asking, about what, the Kidney Foundation?
Yeah, we are one of the national, or big regional sponsor for the Kidney Foundation. We're going to sponsor 5 walks here in Virginia over the next 2 or 3 years.
Oh.
Yeah, kidney disease, most people don't realize this, but it really impacts a lot of people, more than you realize. And one of the chairman this year, Mr. Bergen, had his the kidney donated to him from his wife, and he was a big sponsor, and he happens to be a neighbor of our CEO, and so we got real involved. I used to be involved with the Kidney Foundation in Chicago. I said it's kind of a silent killer. Most people find out way too late that they have kidney disease. So
what is it? If you don't mind me asking, how is it that the Kidney Foundation is part of your interest in terms of support?
Well, there again, it's a big issue in the Virginia and West Virginia markets. There's a lot of people with kidney disease; they don't even know it. And for us, it was an opportunity to do something very, very local with 5 local walks here in the Virginia and West Virginia area. So we're the key sponsor there. There's also a linebacker from the Washington Redskins we got involved in. But then it's a very local issue. I mean, there's not much support for people with kidney disease, you know, dialysis, and just a way for us to reach out and support, help them raise money for that cause. It fits well into their free clinic because I see a lot of people with kidney disease, quite frankly. And so it was a good connection. And again, we're trying to be local. We're not trying to be a sponsor of national organizations or sort of that raise billions of dollars. We're trying to help the local foundations, local free clinics, and things like that to really help our local communities and keep the money here in Virginia, especially Central Virginia.
Now, I'm doing this caricature of you.
Okay. It's pretty scary.
And, yeah. So when I do caricatures, I generally, like, draw as fast as you talk.
Okay.
And it's been a lot of things, but...
I'll try to slow down.
No, you're fine.
I get excited.
No. Yes, it's wonderful. So now, what I wanted to know, if you don't mind, is what is your favorite thing to do when you're not working all the time?
My favorite thing to do when I'm not working on time is to be with my family, especially my girls and my wife,
you know,
on vacation.
Children?
I have two girls. I have a 22-year-old daughter who just graduated from Hope College up in Michigan. She's home for the summer working as an intern. My youngest daughter is 13. She'll be an eighth grader at Stab. And she loves sports, but she's a great student. And both my daughters are just wonderful.
Do you have any dogs or cats?
I have a little dog named Kiwi, a little miniature schnauzer.
What kind of, a miniature schnauzer?
Miniature schnauzer, yeah. She's 9 years old now.
Brown, black?
She's black, salt and pepper.
Oh.
Salt and pepper. Very cute.
How do you spell her name?
Kiwi, K-I-W-I. It's Kiwi. K-I-W-I, just like it sounds. Kiwi.
And your daughter's name?
My oldest daughter's name is Jessie.
Uh-huh.
And my youngest daughter's name is Maddie, M-A-D-D-I-E.
Oh,
my
right.
Last name is Janet. Been married 32 years.
Oh, bless you. Okay. So now, Janet, how do you spell her name?
J-A-N-E-T.
Okay. And what does Janet like to do?
Janet likes to read. She likes to take walks. She loves to be at the beach. She loves to shop in downtown Chicago.
Oh, wow.
We just moved there. Moved here from Chicago. So.
Wow, excellent. Okay, now. Let's get back to the free clinic, if you don't mind.
Okay, no problem.
So, I don't know, all of a sudden there was you on the pavilion with Erica, the director, and I just walked by, actually. I've been doing this for about a year and a half,
right.
And I walked by, and actually it was announced that you guys were going to be there, I think. That's how it happened.
Right.
And somebody Facebook me. Are you a Facebook person at all?
You know, I have a Facebook account. I don't check it much. My daughter's a big Facebook person, but I'm not really a big Facebook person.
Yeah,
so.
It's very a very quick way of seeing what's going on in Charlottesville for me.
Right.
And so I'm always doing initiatives, so I need to know what's going on. So I just click on Facebook, and all the artists are there already.
That's awesome.
So it's a good thing. But now the phone, though. Are you seeing a future in, like, this is technology is moving so fast.
Yes.
Do you feel like, since you've started doing this, it's too fast?
Well, you know, it's funny. I guess when you're in this business, you don't really think it's being too fast. It's fast. I remember when I first started telecom, no one ever thought cell phones were going to take off. I was actually using an old radio phone that was in a car. It was huge. And then I got on the wireless side of the business about 13 years ago. When I was working for GTE, which is now Verizon, but you know, it's just the technology just continues to move so much faster. I think the older we get, the faster it moves, it seems like. But you know, I think it's all good for the consumer. Like I said, you know, we're selling peace of mind, security, being able to stay in contact with your family, being able to do things and be productive.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
I mean, you can. Nintellos has been really, really good. I can go anywhere.
That's fantastic.
I go to Canada. I paint up there farms.
Awesome. Oh,
I have a house in Île-d'Orléans. I don't know if you are familiar.
No, I'm not.
It's right outside of Quebec and city. And it's just all farms. That's how I started my farm.
Oh, nice.
And so I do support farms locally, as I said, you know, with the advent of vitamins being so important and also the oil, you know,
right.
Not spending too much for... and saving it for our other electronics.
Right.
But so now I need to know a little bit more of your nuances. I understand you're a sports fan also.
I am a sports fan. I played college basketball and I still love basketball, but I love all sports, tennis, golf.
And is there a particular team or anybody that you like? Or?
Well, being from Indiana, I'm a big IU fan.
I
also like a couple of SEC teams. University of Tennessee is one of my favorites.
Uh-huh.
I like Duke. It's a good school. And of course, UVA is one of my new favorites.
Yeah.
The Cavaliers. So definitely like UVA sports. That's been fun for my daughter and for the family. So.
And do you have a favorite color?
My favorite color is blue.
Okay. Do a lot of that then. Now, have you been to any of the Charlottesville venues since you've been here yet?
I've been to, down at the Pavilion several times. I've been to the John Paul Jones Arena for the Sugar Land concert, which was absolutely fantastic. But actually, I've been working so much and so busy getting our family moved into our new home, and so I've been pretty busy just with family and work lately. So.
Okay. And so have you found it convenient and sort of, I mean, moving here is kind of like being on perpetual vacation for me. Huh. I mean, you know, you just can just relax, right?
Yeah. No, Charlottesville is a beautiful community. I mean, the Blue Ridge Mountains are gorgeous. The people have been very friendly and very opening as far as their hearts to us, and we've really enjoyed that. So.
And you never know what you're going to get. Some artist stops you on the street and things.
That was a surprise, but it was very enjoyable. I appreciate you being assertive and asking me to be a part of this, because we certainly want to support what you're doing. I think it's, there's a lot of needs in this world, but the free clinic is something I think is very special to Charlottesville, and I'm glad that we support it, glad you're supportive of it as well.
Thank you so much for doing this and to be so thoughtful. In our day and age, it's really a great asset to have people aware of, you know, what's going on in their neighborhood.
Right.
And you're certainly doing that right away. I mean, you just popped over here and already you're doing all these wonderful initiatives.
Well, you know, you gotta get involved. I mean, my mother used to say, you know, you have to bloom where you're planted, and we're planted here now, and we want to definitely bloom and be a great addition to the Charlottesville community, and teach that to my daughters as well.
So you've always been like this. It's not Charlottesville.
No, that is Charlottesville. So we've moved several different locations, but you gotta get involved. Otherwise, you'll be miserable. So I'm happy to be here.
We are so grateful, and you already know that, I guess, that you know people are very grateful already that you've bought the Pavilion. How does that happen?
We're just a title sponsor. I mean, they're again, it helps them to bring in talent that a lot of communities can't get, and with the support of someone like Intellos, they're able to get top-notch talent. I mean, the Friday Night After Five, think about that. You're bringing families together, you're bringing people together, and again, you got the technology to use to, you know, say, hey, I'll meet you at the Sweet Frog yoga place, and it's one of my personal favorites, but there's just a great opportunity to do that with what we do.
And that, to me, is great because of the down economy or whatever. We need people like yourself who support the arts.
That's right.
And if we don't have the arts in Charlottesville, well, I don't think we'd be that interesting, actually.
Yeah.
I think we'd be kind of boring if we didn't have the arts.
Right.
So in your travels, I guess you've noticed that in towns that the arts bring in tourism as well?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, my wife and I, we've always been very supportive of the arts. We both went to school in Hanover College, and they used to have a festival called Chautauqua, which I knew that in New York as well. So we came very involved with that. I think having a liberal arts background, you learn to have an appreciation for the arts and music and things like that. And I think it's a great opportunity. So we really are supportive of that. We try to buy local artists. And you talked about local farms. We used to love it when we lived in Chicago, going to the local farmers market. That's become another new tradition here. So it's just a great way to support the local communities again.
Yeah, that's excellent. So your daughters, I guess, also understand that. Like, had they incorporated some of that in their studies, do you think?
Yes, they have. My daughter, my oldest daughter, has been on several mission trips. She has been real involved with World Vision. She's been in Africa working in an AIDS hospital and school where she's been. She's been in Costa Rica, Honduras. I've been overseas to help build orphanages for kids, and my youngest daughter will continue that once she's a little bit older here and wants to make those kind of trips. But yeah, we definitely believe in giving back, not just to our local communities, but also to the world.
Well, and what color hair does your older daughter have?
She's probably, she's more of a dark, kind of a brunette now.
Okay.
She used to be a little white-haired blonde, but now she's turned more brunette.
It's the woman's prerogative.
And Maddie's kind of a sandy blonde.
Okay.
More like me, I guess.
All right. And so now, when you came to Charlottesville, one of the things I always like to ask people, what was your impression? Like, did you think it was all farms at first, or how did you, what was the way that, you know, you perceived it? Is it like country to you? Is that your favorite kind of place, or is it more like city or rural?
Well, I was raised in the country as a boy, so when I first got to Charlottesville, it was right after you guys had the big snowfalls.
Oh, no.
So when I got here, my first response was, wow, this is gorgeous. I feel like I'm in a winter wonderland. So.
But you had a shovel problem.
I didn't have a shovel when I first got. I was just riding with the realtor that was showing me around.
And she didn't have one either problem.
Yeah, no, she didn't. But I just thought it was beautiful. I love the open space. I love the beautiful horse farms.
So one of the things, of course, is there's a lot of horse farms. But we also have some of the cattle farms and some of the agriculture is very local now. They're getting closer. And people like Dave Matthews has a farm now. And I met some of his farmers at a local farmer's market. I also did a painting, which is in my car, hope it's not baked, of his farm, and before he owned it, actually, because I was here since 2000. So now, one of the things that we also like to discuss is, have you been to any of the venues like the Paramount or anything?
You know, we've not been to the Paramount yet. We walked by there several times. We just have not, like I said, we've just been so busy with the move. And my daughter, my youngest daughter plays AU basketball, so we travel a lot of weekends.
Wow.
And yeah, so it kept us pretty busy. But yeah. We have been to the polo matches out at the King, I think it's the King Winery out in
Jose.
Yeah. That's been awesome. And I've been to one of the vineyards over near Monticello, which has been awesome. So.
Oh, good. So, again, I don't mean to pry, but you could tell me as much as you'd like. But, so, how did you become a CEO, so to speak, of a company that has to do with telecommunications anyway? Like, just, you were a CEO, like, way back or whatever.
Well, I was the chief operating officer for another company. And I'm not the CEO today, I'm the president.
But, president.
But no, I've been just very blessed. I mean, I think it's hard work. I mean, I love people, and I love making sure the customers get a great experience. I've always been a big advocate of making sure we provide the best customer experience and customer satisfaction. So, just hard work and been very blessed.
And so, I also, this is kind of like a kiddie show, so I like to say to people how you perceive education as being part of your ability. First of all, I think most business owners have to be imaginative.
Oh yeah. Exactly.
And I think that's a big part what they're incorporating in schools like the Waldorf School, for instance, now teaches art with math.
Right.
And do you find that that might be something that might have been an inspiration to you, some kind of creativity in your past that you can remember besides you being imaginative to be able to go
through? No, I mean, from early on, I was involved in fundraising through school, through the FCA, and I guess I've always been very creative. And you know, great leaders are actually great teachers and great educators. I mean, that's what makes, I think, most leaders really great is they know how to teach people how to do things, and also they know how to inspire them to respond from what's inside of them versus trying to light a fire underneath them. They try to light fires inside of their hearts and their minds. So I'm a firm believer in that. I mean, it's a big initiative of ours to try to inspire people to be their best and try to give them educational opportunities with what we do at Intellis as well.
So we're going to wrap this up right now because, and I just want to again highlight the fact that you've been such a great asset to our community already.
Thank you.
And that welcome.
Thank you.
And thank you so much for the free clinic monies, because it's going to help the people who are employed sustain the employment there, because they're not going to have to pay like, you know, what it costs sometimes for them to get sick in the ER.
That's right.
If they have prevention.
Right.
So I'm all about that. I'm all about that support, and I'm so glad that you are too. And now I'm going to show you your caricature, and I hope you like it. And here it is.
Oh, wow. That's wonderful. Thank you so much.
Well,
I love it. Thank you so much. I really appreciate
it. And that's
pretty
much it. And
well,
I just want to...
Thank
you. And I want to honor that you're here today in our community. And thank you very, very much.
Oh, we appreciate it.
Thank
you. Good luck to you. Yeah, I want to go.
Ha, 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 ha.